Hi, this is David Wong with the Intel Corporation, and in this video, I'll discuss troubleshooting with Intel Endpoint Management Assistant. Let's start by talking about Intel EMMA's application logging. Almost all logging in Intel EMMA is found on the Intel EMMA server, whether in log files or in the database. These are collected at the server level, and for multi-tenant instances, it's important to note that, at this time, logs separated by tenant are not available. Each Intel EMMA service has a separate log file on the server in the location you see on your screen here. The most commonly referenced log files are the manageability server logs, which can help with tracing issues around failed provisioning of Intel AMT or ISM on endpoints. Also, swarm server logs may help point to issues around agent or Intel AMT or ISM connectivity. These log files are created daily, and it's worth noting that Intel EMMA does not handle log trimming, so especially in a production environment, periodically cleaning up these logs is recommended. Additionally, if you encounter web server errors when browsing Intel EMMA's web interface, one helpful tip is to attempt to recreate the error browsing locally from the Intel EMMA server, where you can expect IIS to display more explicit error messages. And then moving from the server to the endpoints, there is some limited logging done by the Intel EMMA agent, but it's important to keep in mind that many issues on the endpoint, in particular those associated with Intel AMT or ISM provisioning, will get logged on the server. Another common question we get is around audit logging, being able to know who's doing what inside of Intel EMMA. A variety of audit logging data is available inside the database and via EMMA's REST API, though they're not exposed through any kind of reports or user interface at this time. In addition, it is possible to access Intel AMT or ISM audit logging, but something to keep in mind there: if you do want to look at these Intel AMT audit logs on each endpoint, Intel EMMA uses a standard user across all endpoints when it is issuing commands. So when looking for the who, what, and when in endpoint AMT logs, you'll only see that standard user and would have to correlate that information to who is logged into the Intel EMMA server at that time. As you can see, there are some limitations to how audit logging works in Intel EMMA, but we continue to look at expanding these capabilities in future versions. Next, in addition to logs, a key tool you can use to keep track of what's happening in your Intel Endpoint Management Assistant environment is the Intel EMMA Platform Manager. This tool lets you check the status of Intel EMMA components and monitor events for each component in real time. To show you more, I'll run Platform Manager here directly on my Intel EMMA server. To connect Platform Manager to the server components, I'll enter localhost and port 8000 here for the Platform Manager server identifier. And for the Intel EMMA web server identifier, I'll enter my EMMA instance's FQDN, which was set up at installation. The client auth certificate only applies if I specially configured mutual TLS for this connection, so I'll leave that at none. And then I'll provide my global administrator credentials. And now, we're connected. Now, what can we do here in Platform Manager? First, it's important to note there are settings in this interface that can cause an Intel EMMA instance to stop functioning, so do make any changes with caution. Going through some commonly used Platform Manager capabilities available here, we see each of these server components on the left, with the green dots, indicating they're running. If I start with the Swarm server here, each of these components has three tabs. The Component tab lets us halt and launch each component. This can be useful for occasional component issues, just as you might restart a service, or for infrastructure maintenance. Also in this tab are various component statistics that may be useful. For the Swarm server here, we can see exactly how many EMMA agents and Intel AMT devices are connected to the Swarm server. And then next, there's an Events tab. This displays the content of the component log files we discussed earlier in real time. Finally, the Console tab is an embedded command line that offers certain diagnostic and administrative functions. To see a raw list of commands available, you can simply type help here. That's just a quick taste of Platform Manager. More details on these commands, as well as all of Platform Manager's capabilities, can be found in the Intel EMMA installation and maintenance guides. Next, I'll cover a few examples of error messages you may see logged when troubleshooting the provisioning of Intel AMT. And again, these would be visible in the Manageability server logs in the EMMA logs folder on the EMMA server, or in the Platform Manager event tab for the Manageability server. First, we have this warning that host-based admin setup failed with the auth failed code. This would be logged alongside an endpoint's hostname and indicates that for that endpoint, you're attempting certificate-based provisioning to admin control mode. When provisioning in this manner, at the time of AMT or ISM provisioning, the DNS suffix on that certificate needs to match with the DNS suffix on DHCP option 15 on a wired network connection for that endpoint. Or it needs to match with a DNS PKI suffix value set manually in the MEBX interface on the endpoint. The next example is the message warning expired phase 2 record. You'll see that occur if you make a change to an AMT profile that's already been used to configure devices that you're managing. So imagine a scenario where we want to add in an additional wireless network to your AMT configuration profile. When that happens, the Intel EMMA server will realize that, oh, that profile's changed. I know all the computers that use that profile, and therefore I'm going to go through and reapply the second phase of AMT provisioning to those devices. So they pick up the changes to the profile, such as adding a Wi-Fi network. Next on the list here are a couple of potentially transient errors. For example, the message about a WISMAN exception where the underlying connection was closed unexpectedly. This can occur when the Intel EMMA agent is trying to start provisioning AMT or ISM before the Intel Management Engine and AMT driver stack have fully initialized in the operating system. Often this resolves itself once the driver stack is loaded and the Intel EMMA agent is able to talk to it to configure AMT. Where it persists indefinitely, there may be an issue with the Intel EMMA drivers on that endpoint. Next, let's take a moment to talk about the Intel EMMA agent. Once you've installed it on an endpoint, the agent must be able to maintain a TCP connection to the swarm server, by default on port 8080. Here, we've got some commands you can run on an endpoint to help troubleshoot EMMA agent connectivity issues if the endpoint does not appear to be connected. First, this task list command can help determine whether the Intel EMMA agent service is actually running. Next, this netstat command can test if the EMMA agent is currently connected to the swarm server on port 8080. Running the -swarm server option on the EMMA agent itself can help identify the name of the swarm server the EMMA agent is actually attempting to connect to. And finally, using this PowerShell test net connection commandlet, we can see if the EMMA swarm server we found using the previous command is actually reachable on port 8080. For more details, see the Verifying and Troubleshooting Agent Installation section in the Intel EMMA Admin and Usage Guide. Finally, let's talk about troubleshooting CIRA connections. CIRA connections enable out-of-band management through the cloud, and this is accomplished via a long-standing connection from the endpoint's AMT or ISM firmware to the EMMA swarm server. There are a number of potential issues to think about when troubleshooting CIRA connections, and we'll start here with the fundamentals. First, and especially relevant for laptops, endpoints must be connected to power or be actively powered on in order for AMT or ISM to run and for the firmware to attempt to make a CIRA connection. Next, the AMT or ISM firmware needs to have been provisioned successfully. That means, in the Intel EMMA web interface, its Intel AMT setup status should be provisioning completed. Also, the endpoint's associated AMT profile should be configured to use CIRA and not TLS. Another AMT profile configuration item to review is the CIRA network setting. CIRA is always expected to attempt a connection where always use Intel AMT CIRA is selected in the AMT profile configuration. It will also attempt to connect if use Intel AMT CIRA unless on a specified network is selected, but in this case, it's necessary to make sure that the endpoint's current DHCP domain suffix does not match this setting. Note that in versions of EMMA prior to 1.8, this was called the CIRA intranet domain suffix setting, and to get behavior equivalent to the always use Intel AMT CIRA setting, the best approach was to set a non-existent domain suffix in that field. Next, the Intel AMT or ISM firmware must be able to connect to the local network. This means its network connection must use supported interfaces. That could be an Intel wired Ethernet adapter or a properly configured Intel Wi-Fi adapter. Connections via USB network adapters and most docking stations are not supported, except for certain Thunderbolt 4 docks engineered for Intel vPro support. If Wi-Fi or 802.1x is needed to connect to the local network, appropriate configuration must be set in the endpoint's AMT profile. One helpful troubleshooting tip: if the connection requires Wi-Fi profile syncing between the operating system and AMT or ISM, the Intel drivers that handles this synchronization writes logs to the gms.log file path you see at the bottom of your screen. If you search this file for Wi-Fi SSID names or the string profile sync, you can find relevant log entries. Finally, once on a network, Intel AMT or ISM firmware on an endpoint must be able to resolve the Intel EMMA swarm server in DNS and maintain a connection to it. This can be similar to what is required by the Intel EMMA agent, so if the agent is able to maintain a connection, that's a good start. However, keep in mind that, unlike the agent, the firmware operates separately from the operating system, and this can cause some discrepancies. For example, for DNS resolution, if the agent is relying on a hosts file configured in Windows to resolve the name of the Intel EMMA server, that would not be available to the firmware. Similarly, if a required proxy is configured in the operating system, or if the agent is only able to connect to the EMMA server through a VPN connection, that infrastructure may not be available to the firmware either. Finally, a couple additional suggestions when troubleshooting CIRA connectivity. The evergreen option: turn it off and on again. Sometimes, pending Windows updates or other transient issues can interfere with CIRA connections, and a reboot can help. I'll also highlight the link here to the Intel EMMA configuration tool, which is a command line tool that can gather relevant metadata about the endpoint and its Intel AMT or ISM firmware, and this can help identify configuration issues. For further resources that can help with troubleshooting, check out some of these key sections in documentation included in the Intel EMMA install package. And for more support help, you can always search for Intel EMMA at support.intel.com or contact your Intel representative. With that, thank you for watching.